So friends, today I am here to demonstrate a technique of contract relax, which is a technique of PNF, that is proprioceptive neuromuscular facilitation. It is one of the stretching type of technique. With the help of that technique, we can increase the flexibility of the particular muscle. So there are so many conditions where that contract relax technique has been used. Contract relax technique has been used in orthopedic patients as well as the neurological patients as well. So if the patient has an post-traumatic stiffness or the patient has any pathology behind that, the patient is not able to do the active range of motion. So to improve flexibility, we will take a contract relax technique of proprioceptive neuromuscular facilitation as a protocol. So today we have a model that where I demonstrate the technique contract relax. So contract relax technique, today we will discuss that contract relax techniques on the elbow joint. So if the patient is not able to do the elbow flexion, that means there is some pathology in the flexor muscle groups as well. So we treat that antagonist muscle group. So in case of elbow, that biceps, if patient is not able to do flexion, elbow flexion patient is not able to do. So at that case, we work on the antagonist. So in that case, the flexor muscle group or the agonist muscle group is biceps for the elbow. But at that case, triceps act as an antagonist. So we work on the antagonist muscle group first. So what is that contract relax? Contract relax is basically the isotonic contraction of the one of the muscle group. Isotonic contraction of the antagonist muscle group basically. Because we will work on the flexor muscle group. We should improve the range of the flexor muscle group and we work on that antagonist muscle group. That means isotonic contraction of the antagonist muscle group. So what command? Command is very important in that PNF technique. That command that patient must understand it. That means if we give a command to the patient that push my hand, so patient must understand that we have to push that, not pull that elbow back. So this is the, like if we ask the patient first to do the elbow flexion as much as possible, he can without any pain. So we ask the patient to do elbow flexion. Suppose patient is able to do flexion over there. After that, elbow flexion becomes restricted. So that range is about that 60-70%. Like patient has that 60-70% of elbow flexion. But our goal is to complete the elbow flexion range of motion by working on the antagonist muscle group, that is the triceps. So we give the command to the patient that push my hand. That is, command must be isotonically. We ask the patient to push my hand. That is isotonic contraction of the antagonist. So we work on that antagonist. The patient must extend that elbow. So we command that push my hand, push my hand. Resistance must be matched with the patient's resistance. Push, relax. Then after that, the therapist passively flex the elbow towards the flexion. Then the elbow towards the flexion. This is the one repetition. Then again, we ask the patient to do push my hand, push, then relax and then bend the elbow towards the flexion. Every time we achieve a new range and then we start the procedure again with the another new range. Push my hand, push, relax and then bend the elbow towards the new range. That exercise must be repeated for 5 to 7 times a day. And after 7 days or after 3 to 5 or 7 days, we must check that the elbow flexion range of motion must be increased. So, hope you must know the concept of contract relax technique while increasing the flexibility of the one of the muscle group. So, we work upon that antagonist muscle group in that case, but we improve the flexibility of the agonist muscle group. Hope you understood the demonstration of that contract relax. In my next video, we must understand the one another technique, stretching technique of PNF, that is hold relax technique. Till now, goodbye. Thank you.